Hello and welcome to Staying Ahead of the Curve. I'm Jeff Snyder, Vice President, Senior Consultant with CAMAC Retirement Group. And I'm joined today by Richard Linton, Executive Vice President for Operations for Empower Retirement. Rich, thanks for joining us on the show today.
Absolutely, Jeff. Great to be here.
So we're at the Spark Conference, and this is where the asset managers, the record keepers, and other interested third parties get together. And we're seeing a lot of innovation in terms of technology being implemented in a lot of retirement plans. Your area of focus and one of your passions, I know, is the participant experience. And wondering if you could share your perspective on how that has evolved and developed.
Absolutely, Jeff. So first, I'd say I'm really proud of what we're doing at Empower. We're really trying to make a very differentiated experience for the participant. It all starts with setting a goal. If you give somebody a goal, they're more likely to actually think about it, make the right decisions, and actually pursue it. When they're making a goal, though, they've got to do that within the context of all of their financial savings opportunities, right? So it can't just be about the workplace. So creating that environment that helps them understand their whole picture. Third, we have to talk to people in the context of how they think about their financial lives. And people think about their financial life on a monthly basis, right? What bills do I have to pay? What income do I have coming in? And how do I make that all work? That's exactly how they should think about retirement. And then lastly, you've got to make it easy to actually get it done. Once you make a decision, how do you actually execute that decision and take positive action?
I think you make some great points, and we've seen this convergence of benefits. I mean, it used to be, and you know, I've been in this industry for almost two decades now, and I've seen it evolve, but it's really been a siloed approach. You have people that look just at retirement. You have people that look just at healthcare.
Yes.
And but I think you've seen kind of this all kind of come together, and that's exciting. And one of the biggest impediments that we've seen, at least among the millennials, is student loan debt. And I was talking earlier with Tony Aguilar, the CEO of Student Loan Genius, and how they're removing that barrier. And I think, to your point, that kind of paints that big picture.
Yeah.
Just want to get your perspective on some of the innovation that's driving, that you're seeing
Sure.
in the marketplace.
Sure. So, and to your point, depending on what life stage you're in, there are so many obstacles
Yeah.
to wanting to do the right thing and save for retirement, or being able to do Yeah. the right thing to save for retirement. Whether it's student loan debt, whether it's your children's education, or whether it's maybe you have elders living, you know, in your home and you're taking care of, aging parents, things like that. The trick is to really understand budgeting and cash flow. One of the partnerships we've just actually created is with Double Net Pay, and it's all about helping people just understand monthly cash flow so that they can really budget better and then have that money saved and left over to be able to save for retirement. So it's really about making sure people understand, you know, are they optimizing all the incoming money and outgoing expenses to have that extra money to save for retirement?
Yeah, over the last several years, we've been talking about behavioral finance and economics, and certainly that's important in implementing QDIA and auto features to get people driving into the
yeah.
program, but
critically important.
And here at the conference, I know Ed and Jamie, both Ed Murphy and Jamie Ohl from mm-hmm. Various organizations, from Empower and Lincoln, I should say, really articulated that we've got to have that culture of savings. We've got to have policy and decisions that kind of reinforce all the things that we're building into these yeah. participant experiences.
Yeah, and Spark is such a great place to do that, right? Yeah. I mean, here you have all the leaders of all of these different parties who are working to make good savings vehicles available to participants. Let's make sure that that leadership comes together with a very specific and coordinated message that we want to share with policymakers, regulators, so that we can actually move forward as an industry together.
So, you know, when you look out into, and you're responsible for that participant experience and for operations and really driving change and making things better, for a less technical word, what do you see on the horizon over the next 5 or 10 years in terms of some of the innovation and things that you're seeing? I mean, you're probably talking to people in the Valley, you're talking to people in these hotbeds of technology.
Yeah.
How do you, what do you see in terms of bringing it all together for the employee, for the participant?
Well, I mean, it all starts with a true north of wanting to meet the participant where they want to be. So if they want to meet you on, you know, the web channel, on the phone channel, or however they want to do business with you, you've got to be able to do that. But then you also have to make it efficient and easy and the fewest steps possible to actually get them to where they want to be. So, you know, on the phone channel, what we're talking about is how do we give our representatives the best workstation view so that in the most efficient way they can serve a participant's needs and actually help that person have a little bit better knowledge about where they are and what they need to do next than they were. But people's time is valuable, and every participant that calls in, they want the right answer, but they also want us to be efficient with their time because they're all busy people.